list of worst countries in the world. These countries are the worst of the third world and continue to deteriorate financially and structurally as the years go by. Most of these nations are dictated by a tyrannical ruler or military junta, and some just have no government and the country is run by crime or terror groups. Number 10. Laos. Besides being completely landlocked and being the 44th poorest nation in the world, Laos continues to become poorer and poorer. The communist regime in the country continues to become more and more oppressive as their legitimacy declines. Every year people starve to death in this nation and many are fed up with the country's declining economy and infrastructure. The unrest in the nation may eventually lead to complete collapse, thus making the country another Myanmar or Burma. There may be hope, however, but only if this nation adapts more of a capitalistic free trade economic policy as its neighbor Thailand has done. Laos boasts one of the strictest military governments in the world, and deny the results of the country's last election causing more tension and unease. Number 9. Sierra Leone. Poverty and war plagues this small African nation. The blood diamond crisis is most evident in this country as neither the government or the largest UN mandate ever could prevent the violence associated with blood diamonds. The country continues on a downward spiral and living here is not preferred by anyone. Perhaps the only solution to help this war-torn nation is for the African Union to somehow establish controls on diamond exports in the country. Number 8. Mozambique. Doomed since its existence, Mozambique continues to be known for its malaria and AIDS crises. There is barely any safe drinking water in this nation and despite receiving much aid from the UN, the country continues to degrade and slowly crumble as many African nations in this same situation do. The only hope for this nation is a cure for the AIDS virus and a way to make drinking water safe to curb malaria. Number 7. The Central African Republic. Bordering the CAR are the nations of Congo, Chad and Sudan, also among the worst countries to live in. It is most likely the lack of safe drinking water and ongoing civil war which makes this country so difficult to live in. During the genocides in the Congo and in Sudan, many fled to the CAR to escape those conflicts but wound up in another conflict within the CAR. The country cannot sustain its own people nor the millions of refugees. As true in many African nations, starvation and disease plagues this nation and makes it one of the worst countries to live in. Number 6. Myanmar or Burma. After a coup d'etat in the country and the renaming of it from Burma to Myanmar, the country has in power one of the strictest junta governments and there are virtually no human rights. Isolation from the world has made Myanmar the way it is as the government very rarely meets with UN officials or officials of neighboring countries. The Southeast Asian nation is among the 30 poorest nations in the world and much of that has to do with the government hoarding all the money and resources in the nation. Even after a devastating typhoon ravaged the nation, the government did little humanitarian-wise to help its people. Number 5. Chad. Currently Chad contains Central Africa's main water source in Lake Chad, but recently the source has dried up almost completely, leaving the country in a drought and famine. The country borders Sudan and the amount of Darfurian refugees entering the nation are overwhelming the country's capacity to maintain its own already impoverished population. As conditions in Chad continue to get worse, it goes virtually unnoticed as there is little that can be done to stabilize this economically devastated nation. Number 4. Democratic Republic of the Congo. Years and years of war and genocide have torn this country apart and the humanitarian crisis in the nation is catastrophic. The country is currently the second poorest nation in the world in front of only Zimbabwe GDP-wise. The $300 GDP is seen as irreversible and there is no progress that can be made to get this country back to sustainability despite the millions of UN dollars invested in the humanitarian and structural relief of this nation. The country is one of Africa's largest and most mineral-rich, but because of exploitation the people of this country rarely see any profits made from the resources this country has. Number 3. Sudan. Genocide anyone? Well, despite the government denying the obvious genocide in this community, Sudan gives meaning to the phrase FML. Not only do people in the region of Darfur suffer from disease and starvation, but they also suffer from the genocide of the southern Christians committed by the northern Islamic government. Rape and murder plagues this nation and just recently has the international community done anything to stop the genocide. The ICC has decided that the Sudanese President Umar Hassan Ahmad al-Bashir has in fact violated human rights, obviously, and they now recognize him as an international criminal. Number 2. Zimbabwe. The word failure derives from the situation in Zimbabwe. The country currently faces complete economic failure. The country recently printed out the $100 trillion bill, and the currency exchange rate is something like $1 US dollar equals 47 million Zimbabwe dollars. I think that's about it. The country's dictator Robert Mugabe is among the top 10 most hated people on earth and continues to make irrational decisions that are inadvertently destroying the country's economy and overall well-being. Sadly, Zimbabwe used to be a very wealthy nation, but today it is amongst the poorest. Zimbabwe's $200 GDP makes it the poorest in the world, with little hope of economic revival unless there is major political change inside this nation. Number 1. North Korea. Possibly the most isolated country in the world continues to surprise the world with its brinkmanship attitude and its apparently evil agenda. Close to 1 million people a year starve to death in this nation, and it's only getting worse as the government has decided to put all of its money into building 100-story hotel buildings as well as building up its nuclear arsenal. The capital city of Pyongyang seems like a modern capital city, but most of the infrastructure is palaces and monuments built in honor of their leaders Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il, and now Kim Jong-un, who is a tyrannical autocrat that took his father's place in continuing this bizarre leadership practice of not paying attention to your people and building up a massive military infrastructure that has bankrupted the country. Some hope comes in the form of reunification, however. The South seems willing to reunite, but not in the near future, as the two countries are as different as any in almost every aspect. Number 1. Somalia. It's a tie. Perhaps Somalia isn't even a country, more of a lawless land with no hope of a better future. Somalia is run by pirates and warlords and has virtually no economy other than a black market and drug-based economy. Recently, the country has become noticed for its constant pirate attacks on passing international vessels. This is one way the Somalis exploit the absence of government in their nation. Several African neighbors and the U.S. have attempted to establish a government, but the government has dissipated almost completely, leaving the nation to once again be economically unstable and war-torn. Perhaps the average life expectancy of the nation says it all, 49 years. The country, like most African nations, also has AIDS and malaria, which have killed hundreds of thousands in recent years.